better turn the radio off or else we get YouTube complaints. How's that light look?
I suppose that's okay.
I don't know where we're going to start, to be honest. And how it is that you are going to see. Turn this vice this way. And take it out of the vice. Gently put it back in. I don't want to scratch things up too much where the gaskets go. Just pry, high pressure cleaned it. Oh, now you can't see it that way. This is not fair. Life's never fair. Just when you think you've got it worked out, you're wrong. Apparently. How's that? That'll do. And now I can't see because I've got no light. You fix one problem and you make yourself another. And that light is so hot, but LED is so efficient. So efficient, why is there heat? So much energy burn off. It's not funny. Nor is it cool, quite literally to the touch. Now I can see, but light staring me in the face. Never mind, we will work around it. I don't need to see what I'm doing. I can go by feel. Now, we need some grinding paste. I think what I'll do is I'll fight with the valves first. I wonder whether we should just flip that 180. Like so. And I just double checked that you can still see, don't you? And then we put that high tension lead. Yeah. What do you got? A biscuit?
Yeah.
For me, thank you.
Cookie biscuit.
Ah. Very good. Put it up there. Now somewhere in my mess. That was actually fine. I'm not gonna do anything. It's this one. As far as I'm aware. Real thin single line around there. You will never see it on that camera, but it's basically nicely ground. There's no pitting in there, and the inlet seat looks magnificent. So I think what we'll do is actually just fight with that and try and put that back in. Isn't that right, Hugo? How I am going to do that, I really need one of them clamping tools to clamp the spring. I've seen them on eBay. Yeah, I didn't think I'd be doing a lot of this, but apparently I will be. Because they're a pain in the butt to get the valve retainer back in. Without one. I think last time I had help. Or I might have done it myself. Anyhow, seeing as it's going to come out and be a pain to put back in, I wonder whether I zip tied them. So obviously that's how it works. And yeah, I've got to basically put the valve stem through here and then push it over. And then the spring will hold it in place. For those that know, they know. For those that don't know, be thankful it's not you.
Daddy?
Yes?
Hugo's coming to ask you a question.
Uh-oh. What's his question?
What's Daddy Hugo?
Daddy's making a video, but anyway, ask.
I'm ordering my big boat.
You want water in your big boat?
Yeah.
Yeah, Mummy can sort that out. I've actually turned the water off. You just got to reach over and unplug the hose. Mummy?
Mummy's busy.
Well, can you do it after? Because I'm busy too. I'm trying to clean up a valve spring and I think I'm going to zip tie it.
I reckon that's what I did last time. I zip tied them shut.
Do you remember? See how we go. My zip tie spring compressors. Do you remember tomorrow?
What?
Do you remember whether I zip tied these last time?
Zip tied what?
Valve springs.
Ooh.
I reckon I might have had to have, eh? It's the only other way I could think to do it without the pliers, eh? Surprised those zip ties even hold. They've got to be 15, 20 years old. Snipping device. Other end of the bench. Zip tied. They're not very heavy. Nor are the zip ties. Oh yeah, and I reckon I had plenty of those pliers to put that in. Here's a pair I prepared earlier. See, you don't need expensive tools. You just need to think your way around it. It'd make it easier. Was Mummy busy?
Yeah.
Yeah, alright. Let me do this. And then we'll sort out putting your water in. We'll make little videos, not one huge one. Dropped it. Just line it up nicely. Just a bit fiddly in there. I let go of it because I thought I had it. And it's so hard, this steel, that the pliers don't really want to grip it up that nice. Oh, almost. It's around the valve, it's just not in the right orientation. Nah, it didn't work. 180 degrees out. Isn't that Hugo? 180 degrees out. Grab it like that. Yeah, that's the way. And then we'll rip that. Ba-doing. First to perform surgery, you gotta have a casualty. There's one. Okay, now we just check that that's in wrong. I think so. Hasn't bounced off yet. Excellent, looks all nice and straight. I would show you, and I will show you. Half right.
Looks good.
Ah!
Back in. I ain't gonna do that again. Can you see down there? Not really. We're about to change all that.
got another notch that way. Don't mind me. Just moving you all about.
Alright. That can come in.
Uh oh. Where'd that go, Hugo?
It's alright, found it.
Oh wait, we're not going to put this one together anyway.
There's a crampy chicken in my shed.
Yeah, and outside.
Right. Whittle up a valve, Hugo.
Yeah.
I reckon we'll pause the video. Where's my little exhaust valve? That sure is right there. So... come on. Yeah. It's got a few pits in it that I don't like. It doesn't look too bad since I washed it up. What we want to do is get the oil off of here. Do I need to add water? This stuff dries out. And then when it does dry out, it's no good. Oh, come on, man. Yeah, I need to add water. It's too dry. I shall return. Maybe too much. Although it's going to dry out. Now I've got too much water. That's not going to work. Can't remember what I had last time. Probably had the proper sticky thing to do that with, but I would have stuck it in the drill. Trying to clean the valve up, not really the seat, but the seat's not too bad. Now what I lose. Surprisingly. Not done yet, but that gear works pretty nice, even as diluted as that was. You're gonna try not to get it on your stem as well. Yeah, that's what we want to see, more metallic-y stuff. More sand. It's probably more than enough. What we're closer for. Thank you. Getting close. It probably would work in a pinch, but I'm a little more fussier than that. Especially around that side. Again. It's the seat, not the bloody valve, really. The valve looks nice, but the seat doesn't look real. That flash out around that corner there. Anyway. Nice to put that on the drill. It's not like an overhead cam engine where you can stick the drill on the bloody valve stem on the other side. Oh, I wonder. Rubber handled hammer. Rubber handled screwdriver, I mean. Kids have probably got a small one.
Well, that isn't the drill.
Where's my drill gone? Trying to improvise. See if this will work. Nope. Not at all. But the thought was there. Not at all. Out. This is the boring part. My engine's got biscuit crumbs. I think if I don't hurt it, I will use that gasket again. Someone just needs to send me a box of bricks and straightened parts. And just say, here you go. Have fun. I'm going to run the file across that there too. There's a bit of a gap in there. There could be a vacuum leak. Someone's gouged it doing something. Cable's been off at some point. Oh, come on, man. You're turning before. Extra grippy. It's the only tool I don't have. Can't find. Probably do have. Just don't know where it is. It's probably too big for this valve anyway. You watch me, I'll find it after I've done this. But I have not seen it since I did the Suzuki up. I lapped a couple of valves. Not for the valves, but for the seats. In that. Ah, come on, it's gonna be getting close now. The only thing I didn't check. Lucky it's not doing a bloody 10,000 RPM. Water on that rag. With a water gun. Yes, here you go.
Can I take one second?
There's plenty around. Oh man, I really need to drill this, Hugo.
Yeah. Yeah.
I missed my fly. Classic. I'm gonna end this video, I think, and find some way of doing this mechanically. The seat's taken a bit to repair.
I keep missing the fly.
Well, you got to get good if you want to go fox shooting when you're older.
Alright, let's kill this video for now.
Well, done that exhaust valve. Happy with it. I just want to blow everything out for a bit. There we go. The noise has stopped. Ah, opposite corners. I'll be able to spin it and get it out, I think. Doing. Doing. Alright. Again, we've got to fight with this little thing. And this time I've had some practice. I now know, think I know what I'm doing anyway. Ah, oh, come on. Till I drop it. Turn it around the wrong way and drop it. Come on. B. Nice. Right. I probably should have marked it with a texter. So was it I knew. Won't go in for some reason. Something's just not sitting right. Could be the valve spring. Why? Probably because of that one there. Just break that one off. Move it around a little bit. Potentially was taking up vital room, so if I do it in the middle, I might actually get somewhere. I hope. Ah, not working. Rotate it a little bit. I think that's the key to this madness, is get it into the middle. Maybe that'll be okay. It's not sitting on the ground. That one's probably wrong too. Before I cut it.
that's better.
Better, I think. Not quite in the right spot. Yeah, that's got it. That might give me more room. There you go. Oh, you got my watch?
Yeah.
I don't need it. I'm getting all greasy and yucky out here. That's why I took it off. No, I don't need it. You can put it back in the kitchen if you like.
No, I think you need it.
I don't think I need it.
Yes, you
need it. No, I don't.
Yes.
No, I don't even see what time it is. Uh-huh, I got it. Yeah, you go put it back in the kitchen, Hugo. Ka-ding. Gotcha. Here's number one. Let's just rotate the spring. Maybe not. Great. Zip tie might have been stuck in there a little. There's a second one in there somewhere. Come on. Don't play these games. Pa-ding. Oh, right. I think that's in. Sure is. Excellent. So, that's as dark as anything. Lighting in this shed is horrible. But there's a pair of valves in there. Where do we want to start now? Everything out, worked on the piston. Alright. Actually, while I had it in that direction, it's got a problem. This is going to take a while. Take forever.
Oh well, I'll be back when I'm done.
The old man fixed me up a set of rings. I stuck the oil control ring in and I don't need to take anything off of that. Because my rings I got are too big, so stuck the concentrate. Right, got it started. Now what's the end? Gotcha. Gotcha. Now the top one, I have fixed my donk mark. which I can clearly see there's actually two because I dropped it. There's no guarantee I won't do it again, but I just want to check now that that's not too tight there. Borderline too tight. Just there. Did that have any particular? It's got an internal groove on the inside. That one, so that goes to the top. Anyway, done the rest the right way. So come with me for a ride. Everywhere else is sweet. The new rings fit nicely in everything else. In every other groove. Like this new piston, even though it's probably done 40 years of work. Was it 1963?
51 would be 60. 61 would be... Wait, 51 would be 70. 61 would be 60. 71 would be 50. Yeah, 50.
So, that's a 63, so you can work that out yourself. Let's have a feel. That one's tight. That one's good. Just that one. Sharp part of this file. I did play with that a bit. There's a scratch there. I'm going to have to use some silicone on it. Hopefully that seals it. Wasn't me, somebody else. Helps if I'm filing in the right spot. Keep them square. Yay. Hold that out of the air compressor. Said that that groove went to the top. Oh, yeah, that groove. Yeah. Kidding. Alright. That one can go side on, forward. We'll put that one to the back. And we'll lubricate this in a sec. Blow that out again too. Over everything else. Let's go get that one. Cool. Engine oil. Righty. Where can I put that where I might knock it over? And then that's going to catch all my drips, that rag down there.
Kids are killing each other. And that can nicotine the rod. Has to go that away. So we want to put that in. I do have a spring ring compressor, but I don't know that I need to use it, but maybe I do. Because normally I can get them in. Ooh, where's the whole engine? Like that, one at a time. Two compressor engines are going to be a pain in the ass, aren't they? Always. Gaps to this side, so that's alright. Feel it in with a screwdriver. Probably the bottom that's sticking out. Should have just used this ring compressor. The ring compressor. Anyway. I don't know, I might get it in. Baby's not getting away, obviously. Okay. Start again. Down the bottom. Work our way around. My hand hurts from doing that. Anyhow. It's got appropriate drag. It actually feels nice and tight. Okay, I'm happy to just wipe this shit out of here, get my fingerprints out of there. That is happy. And I'm going to go and tidy up the crankshaft whilst I've got it out, and yeah, that'll do for the moment. Ba-ding! I've tidied up the crankshaft. And yeah, I am actually going to put it in dry. And that's at the top. That's in the road. Maybe I should have put this in first. I've encountered this problem before. How did I get around it? I did my orientation all backwards. I don't want to pull the piston out again. Turn it so I can see what I'm doing for a start. It should go past. Just. Oh, Fuck's sake. You are kidding. It's just a millimeter in it. I think I got dirty. Doink. Yoink. Very nice, high five. We have happy time. We'll throw you back in the vase that way. Turn it that way. Fun times. Let's do that up first. Okay, I'll clean all this off. Where's my other workshop rag? Over here. That looks nice. Cool. Throw this sucker back together. Didn't even lubricate it. That is sad. No lubrication. Because I have, just wanting to get that started, a lubrication device over here. Whoops. Lots of lubrication there now. In the back of that hole there. Drink. Cool bananas, and that is that socket there. Give you a lot of room to work, do they? Oh no, we got a chook in the shed. Go away, you crazy chicken. Angry chicken. Let's escape the coop. The whole backyard's fenced off now. But they still jump over the fence. Like, 5 foot fence. Hey Hugo, your chickens have got out. Click. Click. Check this one again. Click. Yeah, definitely click. Okay, that seems alright. Now for the hard part. Knock those silly taps back over. Get this in the stand of ice is another hard thing. That way. Cool. Yeah. Sticky hands. And while we're at it, squirt. I think I'll run it and change the oil pretty soon anyway. A knockometer. Probably not quite the right tool, but it'll do. Just gotta get one corner over. Oh, come on. Yeah, that won't go nowhere. Cool. I'm glad I got those little devices. Those little roll pin punches. So that is that. Now we need some cam followers. Which I'm just going to throw back in. Oh, they need to be ground down too. The last ones are ground, I've made too noisy. All you can hear is the bloody things ticking. Ah, here goes. That might do. Oh, if I get that edge, it'll do. Oh, come on. That is your home. Get the hole there before that thing stops spinning. That's probably enough. That after. That's the starting point anyway. Camshaft covered in shit. Drop some of that down in there.
Getting more fussy than should.
Like so. Now what? Back cover. Do we use a second hand gasket or do we put a new one on? What would I do? What would I do? I need to put a bearing on first too. That too I've cleaned up. What I was going to suss out there is there's an oil passage that way. So perhaps let's just put it back on the wrong way. What
What would that do? Oh bugger, it ran this long. Let's put it back on the way they had it. Really? I want to have this going in there. Serious? Huh. That's actually going, just hitting from one side. Believe it or not. Should be he using his other tools, but... also. Whoops. Sounds solid now. Yep. Yeah, look, stuff it. Back cover. Old gasket. Maybe I can return the other ones. Maybe get my $18 back. And use some gasket goo on it. Just use some goo on it and put that back in. Oh, there's a car there. Blimey. Gasket will never come off after this. If it ever needs to, I probably should keep them new ones. I'll probably get another one of these motors somewhere anyway. For something. But this sealer actually sticks. This one will hold your sump on your aeroplane. What it's actually designed for. This one is designed to stick. This is the aviation one.
Which way do you go? Upside down. Two downs there. That's nice. You need the same royal treatment. Yeah, I did clean that off pretty well. Don't want this. But you don't want this because petrol is anything that cleans it off. Acetone maybe. Don't mind if it squeezes it out though. Just run a petrol-y rag around it and she comes off. Takes a bit of rubbing but it comes off. We didn't put any lube on that, see you later. Lost my stuff. There it is. Do it from the back. Should be right. It'll get there. It's bearing. You're gonna give me trouble. Cool. Put lid on that before I knock that over as well. I'll do with all my other bits and pieces, I wonder. Ah, this lid's going funny. Ah, that'd be good. Now, bulbs. That looks nice. They all go. Where did I put them? That's the little ones. There's a couple. Ah, under here. Should clean them up, but I'm not gonna. I don't wanna. Really exciting. Just before I put that one in, is that the same size as that? Sure is. Where'd that one go inside there? This will be the first one of these where all these aren't stripped. These two vibrated out of my rotary home. They weren't actually stripped when I put them in. I just did my part. Didn't quite feel nice. I never went any further with them. There's two holes in the mounting plate on the rotary hoe and they vibrated out. Fell out while it's been operated. But anyway, that's what helicoils are for. All that good stuff. Right. Click. 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 Now I can't turn that very easy. Make sure that bit of concussion there. We'll make sure that bearing does sit nice in there. And what we can also do. Stuff is horribly sticky. You clean it up before it dries, it's good. But it's still sticky and it's hard to get off. It's like tar. Have any experience with tar, it's like tar. But different. I think I will just leave it and I will actually let it dry where it's not going to get in my way. And then see, that'll clean off. I think we'll whack the flywheel on. Oh, points. They probably don't work now. Water and all sorts in it, on it. So maybe we will do these tolerances first. Feeler gates. Better go see what's wrong with these children. What are you doing? Alright, we'll go inside if you want. You want to stop you from going inside? You don't have to go inside, okay? Only if you want to. Kids. They're killing each other. Not really. But you'd think they were. Not why they carry on. Hey! They're inside. Okay. Ah. Oh, Struth. Where are we? I don't know where I am. 13. 12. There's 12 there. That'll do. A pain in the neck. I still can't get a 12th hour. Yeah, we were thinking that I'll grind too much off. No. No, I didn't. Didn't grind enough. Didn't grind enough. That was for the life of me. I cannot get a 12-hour feeler gauge in there. Oh, just. It does go up. Well, what was it look like if it's 10th hour? Oh, this set doesn't have a 10th hour. fucking useless. Absolutely fucking hopeless. One of these days I'll buy a decent set or find my good set. 8,000 goes in there. Where are we in the grand scheme of things? Here we go.
My sister has a rabbit
dead. Is what? English?
Evie
has a rabbit
dead right here.
Something on her
mouth? Yeah, Evie has dead on her eyes and her mouth.
Dead?
Yeah, she has dead on her.
Alright, I'm really gonna have a look.
Yeah.
I don't know what you've done.